Good morning students. Today we are going to learn unit 3 matter around us. Introduction. The air we breathe, water we drink and the materials we use are made up of matter. Matter is defined as anything that occupies space and has mass. Matter is made of atoms. Atoms are the smallest particle of matter. They are so small that you cannot see with them with your eyes or even with a standard microscope. Matter can be grouped into solids, liquids and gases based on physical characters. Solids. Solids have definite shape and volume. Solids are incompressible. There is little space between solid particles. Solid particles are tightly packed or arranged. These particles attract each other very strongly. Particles of solid cannot move freely. Liquids. It has no definite shape. Liquids attain the shape of the vessel in which they are kept. Liquids can compressible into a small extent. These liquid particles have a greater space between them. Particles are not tightly packed or arranged. They are free to move. The force of attraction between liquid particle is less than solid particle. Liquid particles move freely. Gases. Gases have neither a definite shape nor a definite volume. Gases highly compressible. The space between gas particle is the greatest. Particles are very loosely packed or arranged. The force of attraction is least between gaseous particle. Gaseous particles are in a continuous random motion. Pure substances. A pure substance is made up of only one kind of particle. Pure substance may be element or compounds. Mixture. A mixture is an impure substance and contains more than one kind of particle. In a mixture, the components are mixed in any proposition. We mix rice, dal, salt, chilies, pepper, ghee, and other ingredients to make pongal. Pongal is also an example for mixture. Mixture can be a physical combination of two or more elements. Example, 22 karat gold, which is composed of gold and copper, or gold and cadmium. It can be a physical combination of an element and a compound. Example, tincture of iodine is composed of iodine in alcohol. What is meant by separation? The process by which the components of mixture are isolated and removed from each other to get pure substance is called separation. When and why do we need to separate mixtures? When we need to remove impurities or harmful components from the mixture, example, stones from rice. When the useful component has to be separated from other components, example, petrol from petroleum. When a substance has to be obtained in a highly pure form, example, gold from gold mines. Let us explore the different types of separating methods. Filtration. We use strainer to remove the tea leaves to get the clear liquid. Larger size particles of a tea leaves will be retained by the strainer while the clear liquid will pass through. This is called filtering. Sieving. A sieve is similar to a strainer. Sieving is used when we have to separate solid particles of different size. Example, bran from flour, sand from gravel, etc. Wire mesh as a strainer, sieve is used to separate gravel from sand at a construction site. Churning. When very fine insoluble solids have to be separated from a liquid, as in butter from curd, churning is performed. The mixture is churned vigorously when solid butter will be collected on the sides of the vessel. Both butter and the buttermilk obtained after churning are useful and can be consumed. Threshing. The grains are small in size and also the quantity is very large. Farmers separate grains from their stalks by beating them hard. The grains are separated from their stalks. This is called threshing. Winnowing. The method used for removing husk from grain is called winnowing. This is done by dropping the mixture slowly from a height in the presence of wind. Lighter solids, that is husk, will be carried by wind and will be collected in a separate hub, while heavier solids, that is grains, will fall closer and form a separate heap. Hand picking. In hand picking method, substances in a mixture can be separated by just picking them out with the help of hand from the mixture. Example, separating stones from rice. Magnetic separation. In a mixture containing iron, the magnetic property of iron can be used to separate it from non-magnetic substances. By using magnet, substances that are attracted to a magnet are called magnetic substances. Separating solids using a magnet is called magnetic separation. Sedimentation. Sedimentation is the process of deposition of a solid material from a state of suspension or solution in a fluid. The lighter impurities float while heavier ones sink to the bottom. Decantation. This process is done after sedimentation. The supernatant liquid is slowly poured out from the container without disturbing the sediment. The part that settled down the bottom of the liquid is called sediment. The water that is obtained after decantation is called the decantonate. The process of separating liquid above the sediment is called decantation. Filtration. We use filter papers to remove the finer impurities. Take a piece of filter paper, fold it to make a cone. Slowly pour the muddy water over the filter paper. On filtration, clear water flows down the funnel and the mud settles as residue on the filter paper. The method of separating insoluble components from a mixture using a filter paper is called filtration. The liquid which passes through the filter and comes down is called filtrate, and the insoluble component left behind on the filter paper is called residue. Food adulteration. Sometimes the thing that we buy in the market are mixed with the harmful and unwanted substances. Food can also get adulterated due to carelessness or lack of proper handling, making things impure by the addition of a foreign or inferior substance is called adulteration. An adulterated substance will not indicate the true properties of the original substance. Points to remember. Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. All matter is made up of extremely small particles called atoms. Matter is classified into solids, liquids, and gases on the basis of two important factors: the way the particles are arranged, the way the particles attract each other. Difference between the properties of solids, liquids and gases is due to the difference in the arrangement of the particles and the nature of the attractive forces between them. A pure substance can be an element or a compound, and it can be made up of only one kind of particles. A mixture is an impure substance containing two or more components physically mixed in any proportion. Separation of mixture is done: 1. To remove harmful components, 2. To obtain the useful components, 3. To obtain a substance in a highly pure form. Separation methods to be adopted depends on the properties of the components. Handpicking: for smaller quantities containing particles reasonably large in size to be recognized can be picked by hand. Winnowing: adapted to separate lighter solids from heavier ones. Magnetic separation: used to separate magnetic substances from non-magnetic substances. Sedimentation: settling down of suspended, insoluble and heavy solid particles. Decantation: process of pouring out the clear supernatant liquid without disturbing the sediment. Filtration: process of separating insoluble solid particles from a liquid by using a filter paper. Adulteration: make impure by the addition of a foreign or inferior substance. Thank you.